Hi students, I hope you all are doing well. In today's session, I am going to discuss tricks to solve goal number questions easily. This topic is from surface chemistry chapter. Goal number is defined as is the number of milligrams of lyophilic colloid which is added to 10 ml of gold solution to stop coagulation if 1 ml of NaCl is added. 10% of NaCl is added. Have you understood this definition? No, right? Now I am going to discuss an easiest method so that you are going to understand this goal number concept easily and you will solve the questions from this goal number very easily. Next time onwards, whenever you see this question from this topic, sure you never ever lost marks from that. Let me start this topic. To explain this goal number, first I want to teach you some basic concepts in surface chemistry. Solutions are classified into three types. One is true solutions. Another one is colloidal solutions. Third one is suspension solutions. Colloidal solutions or true solutions or suspension, these three are mainly classified based upon the particle size. If the particle size is less than 1 nanometer, then we call it as a true solution. If the particle size is between 1 nanometer to 1000 nanometer, then we call it as colloidal solution. If it is more than 1000 nanometer, then we call it as a suspension. Our topic is colloidal solution. I am going to discuss about colloidal solution. What is the size of the particles? 1 nanometer to 1000 nanometer. Colloidal solutions are classified into two types. One is lyophilic colloidal solutions and one more is lyophobic colloidal solutions. Colloidal solutions. In this session, first I will discuss about lyophilic and lyophobic, then I will discuss about goal number. Lyophilic. First understand this. Leo means solvent. Philic means loving. These substances, when we add in a solvent, they form the solution very easily because they love the solvent. These solutions we call it as a lyophilic solutions. Example, gum in water. Whenever we take the gum powder and if you dissolve in water, it forms in solution. It forms very easily. Protein powder, solvent water and starch in water. You can write these examples for your board examination. These are lyophilic solutions. The solutions, these when you dissolve the substance in the solvent, they love the solvent, immediately they form the solution. Those kind of solutions we call it as lyophilic colloidal solution. What is the meaning of colloidal solution? The particle range is between 1 nanometer to 1000 nanometer. Fine. Suppose if this gum you dissolved in the water and you got the gum solution, this solution is stable in nature. Means for long months, if you keep the solution as it is, this gum is good. It won't form any precipitate. Precipitate in the sense, these molecules, suppose if they combine together and it forms an aggregation like this, then we call it as a precipitate. Lumps of the molecules forms in the solution, then we call it as a precipitate or here coagulation you can say. Here coagulation is not easy. Coagulation is not easy. Is not easy. Why? Because these solutions are stable in nature. Understand students? And whenever this is not easy, so that this you can keep it for long time, long months, it is stable. One more thing I want to say, that is lyophobic colloidal solutions. In short, you can write it as lyophobic colloidal sol. Instead of solution, you can write it as in sol, S-O-L. Leo means solvent. Phobic means hating. These substances, when you dissolve in solvent, they won't soluble in that solvent. They won't form any type of solution. We call these solutions as lyophobic colloidal solution. We have to use some special methods for the preparation of lyophobic colloidal solutions, like Brady-Clark method, mechanical suspension methods. These are few methods. For example, take gold. Keep the gold bar or gold one block in water. Whatever many years if you keep also, this gold won't dissolve in water. You can say that gold is stable, but this gold solution, it won't form easily. This kind of solution which won't form easily, we call it as an lyophobic solutions. Gold is stable. Suppose if you make it a powder and if you add to water, even though it won't soluble, if you make it soluble by some method, even though after some time, what happens is these gold molecules combines together, it aggregates together and it forms up like a precipitate. So we can say that these solutions are not stable, unstable. Gold is stable, but whatever the solution we are doing, that is unstable, and you can say it undergoes coagulation very easily. What? It undergoes coagulation easily. But lyophilic won't undergo coagulation. So lyophobic undergoes coagulation. So what we want to do is, we want to do the this lyophobic colloidal solution stable. What we want to do? We want to do this lyophobic colloidal solution stable. Why? Because it is unstable. I usually pronounce this as lyophilic and lyophobic, but correct pronunciation is lyophilic and lyophobic, right? And here this is a stable solution, lyophilic is stable and lyophobic is unstable solution. What we want to do is, we want to make this lyophobic solution stable. So for that, what we are going to do, let us see. Take solution. Which solution, students, we are going to take? This one. Lyophobic colloidal solution. In short, you can write it as colloidal sol. And here I am taking gold solution. To this, what I am going to add is, I am going to add 1 ml of NaCl. When already this is unstable solution, whenever we add 1 ml of NaCl, which acts like an electrolyte, immediately when you add this electrolyte, precipitation takes place. Means the molecules aggregates together, it results in the formation of a precipitate molecules like this. How much percentage? This is 10% weight by weight or weight by volume of NaCl. How much 1 ml we are adding? 10% means 10 grams of NaCl we are making up to 100. Total 100, either 100 ml of the solution or 100 gram total. To that we are adding 10 grams of NaCl solution. Whenever we add NaCl to this gold solution, what is forming? Precipitate is forming, which means that it is undergoing coagulation, which means it is unstable. To stop this, to protect this lyophobic colloid, we are going to add another substance. That substance we call it as lyophilic colloidal solution. What we are going to add? Lyophilic colloidal solution. Why? This is stable. Whenever we add this solution, actually what happens is, for example, this is your gold particle which is unstable. This gold particle, what it do? It will combine with one more, and it forms a precipitate. But whenever we add lyophilic colloidal solution, this lyophilic colloidal solution, it forms a protective layer around this. It forms a layer. And here one more gold particle is there. This lyophilic what we are adding, that forms a layer. Whenever it is forming a layer, both gold particles are protected. They are just inside. Then they won't react with each other. In this way, we do the protection. Understand? And here, gold lyophilic colloidal solution, how much we are adding, how many milligrams we are adding, that is called as our, that number we call it as gold number. Is it clear, students? Now you read the definition, you will understand. The number of milligrams of lyophobic colloidal solution is added to how much gold solution? We take standard 10 ml of gold solution. To 10 ml of gold solution, to prevent the coagulation or to stop the coagulation, when 1 ml of 10% NaCl is added. Clear? This is called as gold number. Now the formula of gold number. See the formula of gold number. Gold number equal to number of milligrams of lyophilic colloidal solution is added. Colloidal solution, CS in short I am writing. Solution is added, divided by volume of solution into 10. Why? Because we are making the solution for 10 ml, that's why into 10. That's it. Important point you have to keep in mind is lyophilic colloidal solution, how much is given in the solution, you have to see. That is only the main trick in this. Milligrams you have to see how much it is there. If it is not there in milligrams, you have to convert. And volume of the solution, how much is the gold solution, you have to see. That's it. Other data you should not consider. Based on these two only, you can solve it. Now let us see one question. If 10 milligram of colloid is added to 100 ml of gold solution to stop coagulation, when 1 ml of how much percentage? 10% NaCl is added. This data is not required. This is the most important trick here. When students see this, they feel somewhat they have to use this, but no need of using this. Directly you can solve gold number. What is the number of milligrams? 10 milligrams divided by volume of solution 100 into 10. Then, clear? What is the gold number? 1 is your gold number. Understand? And one more thing, see here the question. This is one more type of question. A is there, B is there. A gold number is 5 and B gold number is 10. Which has more protective power? Gold number is 5 means, what is the meaning of that, students? Gold number is 5. Gold number is 5 means how many milligrams we are adding? Just gold number indicates how many milligrams we are adding? 5 milligrams. Here gold number 5 means 5 milligrams we are adding. Gold number 5 means how much you are adding? 5 milligrams of lyophilic colloidal solution we are adding. 10 means 10 milligram of lyophilic colloidal solution we are adding. Right. So which one has more protective power? 5 grams of A is enough to do the protection of the gold solution. But if you add 10 milligrams only, B can do. So 5 milligram if you add, it is sufficient. You are adding 10 milligram, then only you are able to do protection, means this is a more protective power. This is having more protective power. So you can write that protective power is inversely proportional to, this is most important thing. Protective power is inversely proportional to gold number. Clear? This is one thing. And here gold number, milligrams and volume of the solution you have to take in milliliters. Based upon these two things, solve the test yourself question. This is one test yourself question. Click on pause button and note this question. And one more test yourself question is, this is one more test yourself question. Try these two questions. I am sure that next time onwards, you'll be very confident on this topic. Whenever you see this question, you feel you are so lucky. Thanks for watching. Please give your like and subscribe. Still not subscribe, subscribe to my channel.